Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Let's Learn Dwarf Fortress, Episode 4. Now, something I want to start this episode off with is that if you installed text will be text next, as I told you to do in the first episode, I think, there may be a bug currently with that version that makes your game crash occasionally. If that's the case, instead of using text will be text next, just install text will be text, which is the version above it on the Build Mythki page. Right, so on to Dwarf Fortress. We've made a stockpile. What do we do now? Well, our next step is still getting the dwarves inside and away from the rain. So we need housing and we need food. And for both of these, we're going to need workshops. So this is going to be a meeting hall and a dining hall is my plan. I'm going to make a similarly sized room down here that is going to be sort of a dormitory, if you want to call it that. So we're going to designate some digging here, and we're going to do that after the meeting hall. So, like so. And of course, we're going to have a passage down there as well. Herb derp. Let's just make a similar corridor to what we did before, like that. Maybe we can have a room on the other side. We'll see. Actually, we are going to need a room on the other side. So, actually, let's just make an identical room. It's not pretty, but it works. Oh, I should make that a priority 6 in order not to have them split up too much. There we go. Let's unpause and let the dwarves get to their stuff. So, we're gonna do that now. Well, that's gonna collide my priorities. Fine, I'll just redesignate this then. To 6. And this to 7. There. That'll make him do it in the order I want. So, let's have a look at the surface. How much is still in this wagon? Can I even look in this wagon somehow? I don't think I can. But honestly, it does look empty, and there are no dwarves running up here to get stuff from the wagon either, so... That probably means we've gotten all the stuff down in here. And now we have some rocks left here because you can see they're blinking blue when I go into designate. That means that there's a pond above it, so we'll just dig anyway. Actually, we'll make that priority 2 so that we get that done first. And then we're going to make a zone. Zones are logically enough made with I. And as I told you last time, with the garbage dump zone, I'm going to make a zone in this entire room. And I'm going to press M for meeting area. This means that all the idle dwarves and animals that are not doing anything at the moment are going to walk into the meeting zone and just sit there. Like this dog right here. Now, I'm also going to dump the rocks in here, so we carry them outside. And honestly, these two. Just get all the rocks out of here. Now, there's a thing with when you're dumping rocks like I'm doing now, and not putting them in a stockpile, they're going to be automatically forbidden, which means they cannot be used for any jobs, you can't build anything out of them, and they're just going to sit in their garbage dump doing nothing. So it's not ideal always to do that. We have the garbage dump up here. And apparently we've dumped some seeds and some beer. That's not ideal. But what we can do here then is going to designate and then the building item properties and reclaim. Now if you look at this pile, you can see it's green. If they're green, it means they're forbidden. So I can just double click there with enter and now they are now reclaimed, ready to be used or put in stockpiles as they should be. I'm gonna go back and do that occasionally. I generally don't use garbage dumps to store anything in. Right now it's just convenient to get all the rocks out of here. I'm later gonna make a rock stockpile. Alright, so now we've dug this and we're working on that. I can't make a lower priority, so honestly, I should probably make a higher priority because these are lower priorities. So we're gonna start by making a farm. And I'm gonna make that 5x5. I'm actually going to make 2 farms to begin with. Oops. If you make a wrong designation like this, just press X to remove designation. Right, so like that. And I'm gonna make a small room behind here to hold seeds, so they're close to the farms at all times. Now both our farmers should run up here and do this because it's higher priority. So, there you go. What? There's rock up there? Well, that sucks. I hope that still means we can make a farm there. Otherwise, it's not a big deal. I can always drain the pool into there to irrigate the ground. Actually, that does still look like sand. Oh, there's just... Okay, there's just jaspers in the sand. Okay, fine, that's good. That is not a problem. So now we're going to B, build, and P for farm plot. And you can see, if I point here, it says blocked, and it also said no mud soil for farm. Mud is left by water. Now, if you are unlucky and don't have any soil or sand, you can't make farms like this. You have to irrigate the ground first. The easiest way to irrigate the ground is to just dig straight into the pool. A nearby pool, if you have any. That water will then drain into your farm area and then eventually evaporate. This will irrigate the ground for you. You can also do it with rivers, but then you need some way to block off the flow from the river with a wall grating or a floodgate or something and levers. And you also need some way to drain out the excessive water. And we should probably take that later because that's kind of advanced. Either way, we're going to build a farm plot here. And you make this larger and smaller, just like the embarkation window with U, M, K, and H. And we're gonna make another farm plot right here. There we go. They are designated, and I think we do have a farmer. Yes, we do. So he's now gonna build these. Item blocking site. Yeah. Derp. If that happens, you just queue over the farm plot, and then it's gonna say suspended. Because something blocked it, you just press S to unsuspend it again, and then escape to back out of command mode. Yeah, there's not much to do right now. Now, if you're strapped for wood, which we are not, you can also deconstruct the wagon by just pressing Q and then X. Then your carpenter will remove the wagon. If we have one, I'm gonna check my labors, U and L. Do we have anyone who has carpentry active? We do not have anyone with carpentry, which means no one is ever gonna do that. So, I'm gonna give my woodcutter carpentry. Actually, that was a really bad idea. He's also our mechanic. Let's take our expedition leader, who is what? He is our cook? No, not good. Grower, that's our farmer. Actually, let's just give one of our miners that. That's better. Oh, maybe he did it anyway because he had the labor for a second. Yeah, he did it because he had the labor for a second. Oh, well. Alright, so the farm plots are built. And what we're gonna do now, if you press A, B, C, D, you pass through the seasons. We're gonna start with spring. And in the beginning, you should basically just make plump helmets and pigtails. But I'm gonna have this farm do plump helmets the year around, honestly. And I'm gonna have this make pigtails in the summer and pigtails in the autumn and be fallow the rest of the year. Now, the reason I'm making dimple cups, plump helmets and pigtails is because plump helmets can be used in cooking and for brewing drinks. So it's a really good all-round plant. It can't be used for anything else, but it will keep your dwarfs fed. Pigtails, on the other hand, can also, they can be made into drinks, but they can also be made to make cloth later on. So if we want to get into a clothing business, we can do that. And now we can see our dwarves are napping on the floor, which is going to make them cranky. But our sleeping quarters are not done yet, so we're going to have to wait until they are done. We're also going to need workshops. And right now we don't really have space for workshops, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this area here an area for workshops instead of a bedroom. I'm gonna make this a dormitory, because we need the workshops before we can make a dormitory anyway. So we're going to build with B and then W for workshops, and we're gonna start by making a carpenter's workshop. And you get this, the carpenter's C, by the way. And you can see you have different colored X's. The green X's are passable tiles, and the dark X's are non-passable tiles. This means that if you place this as such, well, it's not exactly correct. But if I place it here, no one will ever be able to walk out of that room, because the two X's are blocking the entrance. But if I place it like this, while there is a blocking X, that the diagonals are free, so someone can walk past it. That is good to have in mind, so you don't block off your dwarves by mistake. I'm going to build this carpenter's workshop right here, and it asks, what material shall I build it out of? And why not just take one of the friggin' rock salts that are just lying around here? Also, did I dump these? If I have them dumped... I do not have them dumped, good. Because if they're dumped, they're forbidden, which means they can't be moved, so they can't build the workshop, because there's a rock in the way, basically. Oh, this is gypsum, okay. We're gonna need a workshop, a mason, M. I'm gonna place that in the other corner here. Make it out of rock salt. We are going to need a still with L to make drinks. I'm gonna place that there. Rock salt. And we are gonna need a kitchen eventually. Oh, and we might as well make a crafts dwarf, which is R. Crafts dwarfs. I'm gonna place that here in the middle, I think. Actually, let's just put it there. Rock salt. We're gonna need a mechanics too, so T. Might as well put that there. Now we have a couple of workshops, and the dwarfs with the appropriate labor will run to the building and build it. I think we have all of these labors. Item blocking site. Mason's workshop was blocked for some reason. Suspended. It's probably someone who took a rock to build another building, and therefore that rock was caught up in a job, and therefore couldn't be moved by the guy who's trying to build the mason workshop. So we'll just unsuspend this and see if they continue. Yep, now it works better. And that is all our workshops. Now, in the carpenter's workshop, we are going to need beds. And I'm gonna count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in that direction, which means 5, 5, 5, that's 25. We can only make 10 at a time, so we're going to do Q, look at the carpenter's workshop, which is this one, and A for add new task, and now you have a bunch of things you can do, but we need beds, which is B, or just use plus and minus to go down the list, but B. And I'm gonna add a full list of these, which is 10. So now they'll make beds out of wood that we can later build. And it has started raining again. Whoopee. I thought we had a carpenter. Oh, right. One of our miners is the carpenter. It might take a while before they actually get to doing that. Damp stone located. Okay, we have a pool up there. It's good to know. How is our farming going? The farmer is running around. Oh, I forgot to make the seed stockpile. So pile, P, food. We'll start with food and just make a pile here. Then we're going to query that and we remove all the barrels with shift E. And going to settings with S, and we basically block everything. But we go down to seeds here, and we permit all the seeds. Now this stockpile will only use seeds, but there's a problem. We have a stockpile downstairs that are also stockpiling seeds. So how do we solve this? We do simply so that we back out of here, and then we use one of the advanced functions up here. T, take from a stockpile. So we press T, and then we go down to this stockpile, and press Enter. Now that means, until this one is full, it will keep moving seeds from the other stockpile onto here. And as soon as something is taken out of this one, it will be moved from the bottom one up here. That means that if this is full, all the seeds will be stored here instead. So this is our main storage, so to speak. This is a very useful thing that we're going to be using a lot in the future. Why is it paused? Oh, damn stone, that's why. Cancels plant seed, needs plum pellet spawn. That means we're out of seeds. Probably because people are trying to move the seeds right now. I would guess that's why. Because I doubt he's used all the seeds yet. Yeah, it's probably because people are moving the seeds around. If a dwarf is holding something, then someone else cannot use that for a job. So that's why that happened. Alright, the digging is completed, and something we should do from time to time is look at status, which is Z, and have a look here. We have round 60 drinks and not a lot of food, so we should keep an eye on this so we don't run out of either of them. Right now we're fine, but we need to keep an eye out for that one. And now our miner is making beds, which is good. So if I press V for view unit, we can see his job right now is construct bed. So he's gonna make beds. And I'm gonna dump all this crap just to get it out of here. Like so. And also these. There is a rock there that we'll be dumping. So our dwarves have something to do. Aw, we have flowers. Cotton grass. Mountain avens. Alright. Might as well dig out this... No, let's leave the gold in the wall for now. Because if I dig it out, someone might steal it, so let's just leave it there. So, maybe we have a couple of beds now. If we look here... Yeah, we have two beds. One, two beds. So I'm gonna start putting them down in here. A willow bed, apricot bed, and that's just build bed, BB. It's not more difficult than that. Alright, it's coming up on stopping this episode for now, but I'm gonna show you the planning mode before we end this episode. The planning mode is kind of advanced, but it's also super useful. If I want to build beds, I want to have this room full of beds, but I don't have the beds right now, which means if I press bed, it's just going to say needs bed. I can't do anything. But if you press Shift P, you go into planning mode. Now, you can place the beds, even though you don't have them, and it will be filled when the beds are made. Now, there are also many settings you can do with this, like you can change the quality of the bed that is supposed to be placed. It has to be a masterful one, or it needs to be decorated. You can select what material it's supposed to be made out of. Right now, I just want beds. It does not matter. Like, any bed is fine. So I've just said ordinary, not decorated, whatever. And I just place the beds. Like this. Now this means as soon as beds come available, someone will pick them up and move them here. I'm gonna remove that extra one I accidentally placed there. Oh, wow! Brain fart! So I'm gonna Q and XX to remove those. Now I also want a door, so build D for door. And I'm going to planning mode. And I want a door there, I want a door there, I want a door there, and a door there. Even though we don't have doors, we can place them. So, there we go. Right now, we are prepared to start making foods and drinks, which you... Actually, we can take that before we quit. In the still, you can make brew drink from plants, which is really useful, because dwarves will need drinks. So I'm gonna have that on repeat right now. And you do that with R, just R for repeat. And we're gonna build our kitchen as well. So build workshop kitchen is... Z, logically enough, and we're gonna build that down here. Alright. That is it for this episode. Ladies and gentlemen, I will see you in the next one. And if you have any questions or if you want me to cover something specific in a future episode, let me know. Toodles!